line ball at ground level, dishing out the handball there. Young, possession of the footy. Wanganeen got it up over the top now to Poulter. He's got a few touches early on that outer wing. Drives inside 50, but Team Grundy chop it off quite easily. Poulter getting involved here. That towards half back where the mark is taken by Spain.
Gets it on by hand immediately to Poulter. Poulter wheels out wide, maintains position.
Towards half back, just over the outstretched fingers of his teammate. Poulter received the handball.
Ryan, who uses his body to knock Robbins out of the marking contest and feed the ball up by hand towards Poulter. And
I guess consistency as well in their games when they don't play together all the time.
Poulter wins another set clearance. This time goes by hand looking for Dumas, and he runs on the ball, takes it clean.
Big lump of a lad kicks towards Poulter on the wing over his head. Sits nicely for Grubb, who goes further afield to the handball. Long handball. Poulter did well to gather it in. Goes short, just past the outstretched arm of...
Across the line for a behind there to Team Herd. They're 10th behind. They're 2 goals, 10-22 as the kick comes in now towards Poulter. Feeds off by hand. Team Grundy immediately forward of centre now to Murley. Handball to Beacon. He gets slung in the tackle. He gets the handball off to Poulter before doing so. And he wins a free, and they take the Beacon and they take the advantage, Poulter, and he may have been slung.
Yeah, as I said earlier, they just can't take their... They haven't been able to take their opportunities, Team Hearn, have they?
They certainly haven't. It's been a... Not that they haven't had them. They just have missed a lot of shots on goal, whereas Team Grundy have been quite accurate as Poulter's kick brings it back towards the wing position. Hang up just a little spoil there from Young. Handball came out. Clifton couldn't pick it up. Poulter could get it back on the 1-2 from Smith.